Magandang araw mga kapamilya. Today is Saturday of the 23rd week in Ordinary Time. Our Mass presider is Father Boogie Tapdoro of the Society of St. Paul. Entrance Antiphon. You are just, O Lord, and your judgment is right. Treat your servant in accord with your merciful love.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let us now acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, by whom we are redeemed and receive adoption, look graciously upon your beloved sons and daughters, that those who believe in Christ may receive true freedom and an everlasting inheritance. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. My beloved ones, avoid idolatry. I am speaking as to sensible people. Judge for yourselves what I am saying. The cup of blessing that we bless, is it not a participation in the blood of Christ? The bread that we break, is it not a participation in the body of Christ? Because the loaf of bread is one, we, though many, are one body, for we all partake of the one loaf. Look at Israel according to the flesh. Are not those who eat the sacrifices participants in the altar? So what am I saying? That meat sacrificed to idols is anything? Or that an idol is anything? No, I mean that what they sacrifice to demons, not to God. And I do not want you to become participants with demons. You cannot drink the cup of the Lord and also the cup of demons. You cannot partake of the table of the Lord and of the table of demons. Or are we provoking the Lord to jealous anger? Are we stronger than he is? The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
To you, Lord, I offer a sacrifice of praise.
To you, Lord, I offer a sacrifice of praise.
How shall I make a return to the Lord for all the good he has done for me? The cup of salvation I will take up, and I will call upon the name of the Lord.
To you, Lord, I offer a sacrifice of praise.
To you will I offer a sacrifice of thanksgiving, and I will call upon the name of the Lord. My vows to the Lord I will pay in the presence of all his people.
To you, Lord, I offer a sacrifice of praise.
Alleluia, alleluia. Whoever loves me will keep my word, and my Father will love him, and we will come to him. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Luke.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, a good tree does not bear rotten fruit, nor does a rotten tree bear good fruit. For every tree is known by its fruit. For people do not pick figs from thorn bushes, nor they gather grapes from brambles. A good person out of the store of goodness in his heart produces good, but an evil person out of the store of evil produces evil, for from the fullness of the heart, the mouth speaks. Why do you call me Lord, Lord, but not do what I command? I will show you what someone is like who comes to me listens to my word, and acts on them. That one is like a man building a house, who dug deeply and laid the foundation on rock. When the flood came, the river burst against that house, but could not shake it, because it had been well built. But the one who listens and does not act is like a person who built the house on the ground without a foundation. When the river burst against it, it collapsed at once and was completely destroyed. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
A blessed day to everyone. Magandang araw, Kapamilya. Today we are on the Saturday of the 23rd week in ordinary time, but it's also the same time, the end of the teachings of Jesus on the Sermon on the Plain, or the Beatitude. And here it is clearly given to us that the message is not just about listening to the Word of God, but we have to act on it. It is not just about receiving the Word of God, but also we have to live it in our day-to-day life. And this is the application of the teachings of Jesus, not only intended to the listeners of his time, but it is intended to all of us, that we, followers of the Lord, should not only listen to the Word of God, but allow the Word of God to inspire and motivate us, to allow the Word of God to become our way of life. Jesus makes use of the two imagery in the Gospel. The first image is that of the garden. And the takeaway lesson from here is that it is a passage of good and evil. And some claim to have faith, but do not live out of it. And therefore, it becomes a proof of what they produce. And here, it is a challenge for all of us to be always cautious of our faith and the way we live our faith. Because like the fruit, we will always bear fruit, and the fruit should reflect on the tree. Kaya mga kapamilya, if you are really grounded on the tree of life, which is the Lord, then we will be able to produce the fruits of the Holy Spirit: kindness, generosity, charity. For from the fullness of the heart, the mouth speaks. Kaya ito yung takeaway from the image of the garden, that we must be attached or always connected to the tree, who is none other than the Lord, so as to produce the fruits of goodness in our life. The second takeaway or lesson is that our action result from our character, revealing what is inside our heart. We cannot just go hidden all throughout our days. We cannot just pretend that we are good to some people. It has to be natural for us to be good. Just like in the Gospel, the Lord reminds us that if it is goodness is inside our heart, then we will also act goodness in our relationship with others. If hatred is inside our heart, then vengeance will become the action or the things that we do outside of us. So that's why we cannot just pretend that we are good to some and not good to others. As followers of the Lord, we have to be good inside out, and our act of goodness and kindness has to become our way of life. The second image is that of construction, the foundation. And the third lesson or takeaway from the Gospel is that the choices I make in life will be reflected in the fruits of those choices produced. It means that our life, to become strong amidst the challenges and temptation, has to be built on the strong foundation, which is none other than the Lord. Because, you know, we battle against sin, and the only way to save us, not to protect us, is none other than grace. That is why the Lord should become the strong foundation of our life. Kaya anumang pagsubok, hindi tayo matitinag. Anumang harang, no? Anumang problema sa buhay, hindi tayo matitinag. Dahil si Lord ang ating pundasyon sa buhay. Just like any construction, just like any house, building for that matter, the foundation is very much important. So today, as we continue this Mass, I hope the image of the garden and that of the construction help us to live goodness and be able to share that goodness to the people around us. When problems and challenges arise, St. Paul in his letter to the Corinthians reminds us, we are one body, we are one bread, and therefore let us help one another in living good and making goodness and kindness to people around us. We are one body, the church, and therefore let us help one another produce goodness in our life. We are one bread, one church, one body of Christ, and therefore let us help one another becomes a community of believers joining towards the very flock of Jesus. This is our prayer. This is our wish that we continue to live as one body of Christ, partaking in the goodness and living out the goodness of the Lord in our life. Amen. Prayers of the faithful. As Jesus was closing his sermon on the plain, he told his disciples that listening to his words was not enough. The disciples must act on them. Let us pray that we may become attentive to God's word and put it into practice. And for every petition we pray, Lord, hear our prayer.
May we be doers of the word and not hearers only, not hearers who forget, but doers who act and who will be blessed in what we do. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
May preachers of the word of God be the first to allow it to touch their lives, challenge them, impel them, and become incarnate in their lives. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
May we dispose ourselves to listen to the word of God, rediscovering the value of silence in order to meditate on the word that comes to us. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer. Let us also lift up to the Lord the intentions offered in this Mass, especially for those who are celebrating their birthday and wedding anniversaries today. And let us also pray for the eternal repose of our faithful departed and for those who are sick, as we pray for healing and full recovery of Father Tito Caluag. And we pray, no, that he will be back soon to preside over the Kapamilya Daily Mass. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Prayer for the 125th anniversary of our nationhood. Lord of history, as we start our journey toward the 125th anniversary of the birth of our nation, accompany us on this project of building society with genuine freedom for all. Freedom rooted in compassion, justice, and truth. Freedom from poverty that deprives the majority of opportunities to better their lives. Freedom from hunger, homelessness, and lack of quality basic services in healthcare, education. Freedom from deception, lies, and manipulation. Freedom to be active and positive builders of our nation. Give us the courage and inspiration to relentlessly build a nation truly free for all Filipinos. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received this bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become our bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received this wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Lord, wash away my iniquity, cleanse me from my sin. Pray that your sacrifice and mine may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
O God, who give us the gift of true prayer and of peace, graciously grant that through this offering we may do fitting homage to your divine majesty, and by partaking of the sacred mystery we may be faithfully united in mind and heart. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, O Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. His death we celebrate in love, his resurrection we confess with living faith, and his coming glory we await with unwavering hope. And so with all the angels and saints we praise you, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of a new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sin. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, who said Vincula, our Archbishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostle, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coerced to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostle, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sin, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace be with you. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. An act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Let us now pray the prayer for the end of this pandemic.
Merciful and compassionate Father, we humbly come to you to find forgiveness and life. We come to ask for your grace and guidance as we emerge from this pandemic. Bless all those who help see us through the challenges the pandemic brought, those who tirelessly work to render genuine service, especially to those who suffered the most. Guide the people tasked to find cures for this disease and to stem its transmission and to end this pandemic. Heal all who are afflicted. Grant eternal rest to those who have died and consolation to their loved ones. As we move forward, grant us the grace to see clearly, choose well, and act right in order to build a nation closer to your kingdom of justice, truth, equality, faith, hope, compassion, and love. Grant all these through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
We fly to your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Do not deny our petition, but deliver us always from all dangers, O glorious and blessed Virgin.
Amen.
Our Lady, help of all Christians and health of the sick.
Pray for us.
Our Lady of Fatima.
Pray for us.
Saint Joseph.
Pray for us.
Saint Raphael the Archangel.
Pray for us.
Saint Roch.
Pray for us.
Saint Lorenzo Ruiz.
Pray for us.
Saint Pedro Calungsod.
Pray for us.
Most Sacred Heart of Jesus.
Have mercy on us.
Santo Niño de Cebu.
Have mercy on us.
Divine mercy.
Have mercy on us. Let us pray. Grant that your faithful, O Lord, whom you nourish and endow with life through the food of your word and heavenly sacrament, may so benefit from your beloved Son's great gift, that we may merit an eternal share in his life, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Let us now pray the prayer for peace and joy for the world. Father in heaven, to you we offer this prayer in the words of our Holy Father, Pope Francis. We have so much to do, and we must do it together. In the darkness of the conflicts we are living through, each of us can become a bright candle to remind us that light will overcome darkness and never the other way around. To us Christians, the future has a name, and its name is hope. It is the virtue of the heart that does not lock itself up, does not dwell in the past, and not only survives the present, but is able to see tomorrow. Bless our world, Father, with the peace and joy that the cross and resurrection of your Son, our Lord Jesus, won for us. For all those affected by calamities, natural and man-made, for all those who suffer from the structural injustices of our time. Amen. Our Lady, Mother of God and Mother of the Church,
pray for us.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you all, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our celebration is ended. Go and announce the Gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you for celebrating with us. God bless and stay safe.
Dahil sa mataas na antas ng kahirapan sa Pilipinas, malaki ang suliranin sa kakulangan sa sapat na pagkain at kawalan ng sustainableng hanap buhay. Hangad ng Caritas Philippines na matulungan ang iba't ibang sektor sa agrikultura upang mapataas ang produksyon at ani at maibenta ang produkto sa tamang halaga at merkado upang mapaunlad ang bawat pamilya at komunidad. Halina at sama-sama tayong maging bahagi ng pag-aalay para sa kabuhayan ng lahat na nangangailangan at nasa kahirapan. Sapat na pagkain para sa kalusugan ng lahat at mayamang bukas.